ora, no mai, come into my house. This is where I come from, Te Urewera. I stole this map from my mum's before I came to Wellington. For me, it's just really nice to wake up and get to know my whenua every single day. I can't remember the first time I heard the term urban Māori, but one term I really remember from growing up is the term city Māori. People came home who had been away in Auckland and Wellington, whatever, and almost had to prove that they were still Māori enough to be standing strong on our marae. I think for me, it was a little bit scary to come to the city and become one of those city Māori, and it was almost a dirty term. But what I've learned being in the city is that urban Māori are not disconnected. Not always, anyway.
Among urban Māori, one of the groups that I think is really significant is takatāpui. Pre-colonisation, Māori attitudes to gender and sexuality were less binary. Missionaries introduced Christian attitudes, and those were widely adopted by tangata whenua. Our people have always been open about sexuality, but it was colonisation, the restrictive word of the Bible, that squashed out any ideas of sexuality and gender that weren't wahine kititane and monogamous marriage forever and ever.
This word takatāpui, I think, has been around for a long time, but was reclaimed in the 1980s by people who stood at this intersection of identifying on this broad gender and sexuality spectrum, but also being Māori. I suspect many takatāpui came to the city to escape those more colonised attitudes of our traditional papakāinga. Today, I'm going to spend some time going out, talking to takatāpui around what it means to be a Māori in an urban environment. We're here in Orfido Bay on the south coast of Wellington City. This is Nautilus Creative Space, and this is where Ariki Brightwell does most of her artwork. Ariki is an artist, she's a cosplayer, she's a roller derby extraordinaire. She's also the kaihotu on the waka in Wellington City. So we're going to talk to Ariki today about what it means for her to be young, urban Māori and takatāpui in Wellington.
Kia ora. Kia ora, ehua.
Nice to meet you.
Want to come and check the place out?
That's awesome.
Kāpai, kāpai.
Oh my gosh.
This garage was a bus garage. It's been transformed into what you see before you. An artist centre, cultural centre. Gigs happen here. Everything happens here, cool. Essentially. Yeah, so it's quite an amazing place, and it really truly reflects the kind of person I am. I was brought up in Gisborne. Leaving Gisborne, I came straight to Wellington City and have resided in central area since. Absolutely, I do consider myself urban Māori and I represent myself as such. I've always done art growing up. My father's a master carver, he's a tohunga for kairo. I went down the more kind of illustrative route, especially with cartoons and animation that I grew up with in the 90s, so I was that child. I identify as wahine. It wasn't until the internet came, with dial-up, that I started to type in some kupu, like gender and things, because I just felt weird. I just felt like something wasn't quite right about me in terms of how I felt in my own shoes. I was terrified to let anyone know. The people I met in Wellington, the city itself, everything I encountered and saw started to open my eyes to who I really was. The problem with the city, though, is that it can absorb you. You assimilate. And a consequence of that can be you lose your connection with your whenua and your people. You're too busy living in the world trying to make a living, and so you do not focus anymore on your reo, your whakapapa, or things like that. What I've known, what I've learnt too from some of our kaumātua, takatāpu identity pre-colonisation, our people have always experimented or dived into our sexuality. Especially our gender, that's one of the main parts of our culture, it's displayed on our carving. We came from Hawaiki, and if you look at our people from Hawaiki, especially our cultures there, we have our whakawahine on those islands, even still today, still acknowledges as who they are, as part of the culture. The sad thing about here in Aotearoa, as Māori, we kind of lost that connection, especially on that spectrum. Even though the heavy presence on the islands, in terms of religion is quite strong, You know, you still have the whawhawhine, you know, you still have the whakawahine from the Cook Islands. You have the rere from Tahiti. You know, they are still there and acknowledged.
You've made this point that Māori in an urban setting have historically been disconnected from their culture by the fact that we're in this urban place and it's different from where we've always been. For Takatāpui, is the city not a place that has also empowered in terms of allowing us to express an aspect of our identity that might still be uncomfortable for our whānau at the marae?
Absolutely, absolutely. Rangatira, who fled their whānau due to prosecution or being disowned, they go to the city now for refuge because the city accommodates them. And that's due to that one side we try to rely on shunning you away because of you decide to, you know, your wahine, your tāne, your gay, or anything you decide to do, that side tends to react negatively to it, which is the Māori side. And so my thing is that this side's really got to step up and go back to our teachings, you know, aroha, manaakitanga. All that sort of stuff encompasses who we are, and it's the first thing we do when we greet one another. Our people got to remember that. They should always accept them for whoever they are, because that happened to me. My whānau accepted me. Because they supported me, I had my roots. And then I went to the city and found my whānau in the city, but I still had my connection at home, so that made me a strong, much stronger person compared to someone who goes to the city and doesn't have that. They have to start all over again.
Now we're going to go and meet Kayla Rian. Kayla moved to Wellington in the late 70s. I think she has a really different experience of being an urban Māori person in Wellington City compared to what myself or Ariki might have had today. So hopefully we're going to share some good kōrero with her about that. Kia ora.
How are you?
I'm good. Oh.
I'm an indigenous Māori whakawahine who was born here, and there's no ifs and buts about it. When I discovered I was different, there are three stages. One is self-realisation, then there is self-acceptance. So I accepted who I was, and then of course it's transition. And I've been doing that for like 40-odd years. The reason I don't smile is because I had a shit-ass childhood. My father was kind of a prominent person, and out of respect, I knew that I was different and whatever I did would reflect on the family. So I made the choice to move away. Late 1970s when I moved into Wellington, I was about 16 then. I found my own kind of people in Wellington City. My friends that I made, they were the same as me, and we shared one thing, we're all Māori. All of the sex workers were family. When we went out, it was like meeting the sisters. You stopped, you talked about what you did, what you're gonna do. We had our own social life, so it's like just going to someone's house for a coffee. Girls would be lined up or sitting across here. Sex work was just like a minor part of it. It's just like grabbing hooey all the time. You go to any marae, you see one of us whakawahine. We're in the kitchen. We're with the aunties. We are workers. We don't argue about things on a marae or what have you. We get up and we do it. And we're respected for it. And just because I'm trans does not mean that I do not have feelings about where I come from, who I am, and who I'm a great-grandchild of, for instance.
So we're heading now up to Victoria University. This is an important place for me because I've just finished my undergrad studies there, and that was the reason why I moved to the city in the first place. And we're going to meet Kevin Honui. Kevin is currently doing his PhD looking at Takatāpui understandings of well-being. Kevin's also one of the trustees and founding members of Te Whanawhana, who we're going to go see after this later tonight.
I was born in Rotorua in 1960. My parents are school teachers. They were both from the country as well. So lived in Rotoriti for a year or so while they were teaching there, and then at Rotokawa, and from there I came down to Wellington in 1979. I was gay from a young age in terms of self-awareness. So that was a character trait that I kept hidden. To me, Māori are diverse. We're not just ones that live on the pā. We're everywhere. What's normal has actually been everything we could possibly want to be. And all the things that our tikanga talk about in terms of mana, upholding mana, in terms of, you know, tautoko, manaaki, about thinking about our spiritual side, our wairua, all those things still count and are as important today as they always have been. So we can't, I believe, as Māori, be fixed and rigid. Our tikanga still has to reflect all those values, though it might look slightly different from how it was, you know, one generation ago, two generations ago. It's got to respond to the context of the day.
So it's about 6 o'clock at night and it's just got dark outside, and we're going to go now and see Te Whanawhana. So Te Whanawhana is kind of a place for Takatāpui community in Wellington City to meet. Start off with a bit of a karakia, and then I've heard we do a bit of a session of whakawhanaunatanga and what we've been up to in the weekend, and then hopefully get into a bit of waiata, a bit of poi. And I'm a bit rusty, but I guess we'll see if I can pull out my skills from primary school. So what have we taken away from this journey? We've talked to Takatāpui young and old. We went looking for what it means for them to be Takatāpui in the city and how they find identity. And that's part of this wider story around being urban Māori. I think what I've learned is that there are advantages and disadvantages to being Takatāpui in the city. Kayla mentioned earlier that one of the advantages is that the city provides freedom to be yourself. One of the disadvantages is that you have to look further to find your sense of whanaunatanga, though it is there. Overall, what I've taken away is that for Takatāpui in the city, they've gone on this really significant journey. Not only are they looking at if they're Māori enough through whakapapa, if they're Māori enough through their location, but also if they're Māori enough through just being Takatāpui. I think there is a really significant journey. They are peeling back these more colonised attitudes within Aotearoa, returning back to something we have always been. As a wise man once said to me, to be Māori is to be everything you could possibly be. And that, I think, is pretty much the gist of it. E kore au e naro, he kākano I rui a mai e rangi atia. Ka kite anō.
This program was made possible by the RNZ NZ On Air Innovation Fund.